It's terror versus democracy in the valley. 51 terrified panchayat leaders have resigned in the valley after receiving threats from terrorists. And despite the situation getting out of hand, the state's chief minister Omar Abdullah has failed to take any concrete measures to deal with the situation.
Living in a state of fear, forced to choose between saving their lives and keeping their jobs. The sarpanches and panches of Kashmir cannot be blamed for choosing life over elected office.
The government has already issued instructions that there will be night patrolling in all those areas. Number one. Number two, if in case there is any person who feels insecure, he can be provided security.
The situation is only expected to get more grim. With sources telling your channel that more panches and sarpanches in North Kashmir will tender their resignations today.
Panches under threat continue to quit through the day as the government, other than mere lip service, failed to take steps on the ground to make them feel secure. In a way, playing in the hands of the militants whose attempts at spreading terror in order to ensure the collapse of the third tier of democracy seems to be working.
The opposition unforgiving in their attack on Chief Minister Omar Abdullah.
Army or security forces cannot guard their representatives. It is the people who are the security. But what do? You don't even empower these people.
Many are even questioning Omar Abdullah on his repeated demand for the revocation of the AFSPA.
Should we remove this provision? An army is not on the ground. This particular aspect of restricting and constricting the area of operations of the terrorists will go away, and they will have an opportunity to strike at more soft targets at the higher echelons.
The question now is, with more and more sarpanches resigning in Kashmir, does New Delhi have any option but to go in for a fresh crackdown on Pakistan-backed terror in Kashmir? Bureau Report, Times Now.